We're going to continue our ratio proportion discussion here. So in the last video, we were looking at how if I have two ratios, right, and in this case, I have them written in fraction form. If I have two ratios and I want to check if they're equivalent, I simply multiply straight across to see if they're the same, right? And in this case, they are. So I could say, I come up with the same number, right? Right here, 6 times 2 is 12, 12 times 1 is 12. So I could say that 6 twelfths is equivalent to 1 half. And again, if you are at all familiar with fractions, you would be able to see that. Oh yeah, 6 is half of 12, so I know that it has to equal another fraction that's written as a half. But basically what I have written here is what we would call a proportion. A proportion is a statement that where two ratios are equal. And so let's look at an example of how we could use a proportion statement to solve problems kind of in our everyday life. Okay, so I have a photograph that is 5 by 7. Okay, I have a 5 by 7 inch photograph. And I want to enlarge it proportionally so it keeps the same relationship between the width and the length. Okay, I don't want it to get like stretched too far in one direction or the other. I want the new width of the photo, the enlarged photo, to be 8 inches. So what should my new length be? So I'm just going to make myself a little chart here, okay? Basically, what they're asking me is to compare the width to the length, right? And then I have two different sizes of pictures. I have my original size, and I have my new size. Okay, so I'm just going to make myself a little chart. And I am going to say, okay, the width of my picture, I'm going to say, is 5 inches. And the length of my picture is 7. And I want to find out what the new length would be if it was 8 inches in width in the new size picture. So basically, if we look back at this, right, and how I had a proportion statement, I am comparing this, right? And so all I have to do is multiply in order to figure out what would make this, what would fill this spot to make it equal to this direction's multiplication. Well, that's difficult, right? Because 8 times 7, that's 56. And that's not a number that's evenly, I have to divide by 5 in order to guess what this number is. And so that's going to be our new sort of thing to think about. I'm going to multiply the two numbers that are diagonal, and I'm going to divide by whatever's left. Okay, and in this case, I think I'm going to get like a fraction, right? Because I know that 8 times 7 is 56. I know this is a number that's not going to be equally divisible by 5. 5 is going to go once. 0, drop the 6 down. It goes in once. Let me get this on the screen so you can see what I'm doing here. I have 1 left over, so it's going to be 11 and 1/5. Or, kind of running out of room here, let me grab a different board here. Or I could do this, right? I could write it as a decimal point. I could say, so we were at this point, drop in a decimal and a 0, drop my 0 down, put my decimal point up top. There we go. Or I could say 11.2. So if I go back to my chart over here, my new length would be 11.2 inches. So that's how we figure the unknown term. We're going to multiply the ones that are diagonal across from each other and divide by whatever is left. Let's look at another example here. I have the ratio 2 to 3, and I want to make it an equivalent to something with a 12, kind of in the bottom of my fraction, right? The denominator of this fraction. What is this going to be? What is that x going to be? Well, what do I have to do first? Well, the steps I just talked about, we're going to multiply the ones that are diagonal, right? I'm going to times, and I'm going to divide by this guy, by that 3, because he's the one that's left. Okay, so here we go. 12 times 2 is 24, right? And now I'm going to take 24 and divide it by 3, which is 8. So I know in this case that x equals 8, because that is the only number that when I, you know, multiply with the 3, it would equal that 24 that these two guys equal to make it proportional. Let's look at another word problem example here. Grab my eraser. Okay, so Jean can shoe 2 horses in 3 hours. So at this rate, how long should it take him to shoe 3 horses? So in this, I'm comparing horses to hours. Sometimes in a word problem like this, it's good to sort of write out a little chart for yourself. I like to do it because it keeps me from getting really, really confused. So that's always good. Okay, so this is my original ratio. You don't want to get confused in math, right? My original ratio was 2 horses in 3 hours. And my new amount, right, they want to know how long it should take Jean to shoe 3 horses, right? And so the question that it asks me is how long? That's a time word, right? So I should have my empty spot down here in the time, the hours area. But in case I don't, that's always kind of a good check for yourself. You know, so how long should it take him? Oh, that's a time question. So this is what I'm looking for. So again, we're going to multiply and divide. Okay, so 3 times 3 equals 9. I'm going to divide by 2. 2 into 9 goes 4 times, which is 8. I have 1 left over. I'm going to drop in a decimal point and a 0. Bring my decimal point up, drop my 0 down. 2 into 10 goes 5. So if he can shoe 2 horses in 3 hours, it should take him 4.5 hours to shoe 3 horses. We're going to expand on this in the next video.